Dive deep into timeless tales. Join our Bible's literature series where ancient stories come alive. Discover the Bible like never before as captivating narratives, not just sacred texts. Your literary adventure awaits. Dive into the Bible with us, a tapestry of tales and truth, where the sacred texts shape community conversations.
Lecture 2, The Creation and Disorder in the Book of Genesis. In this lecture, we commence our exploration of the Bible by delving into Genesis, with a focus on its first 11 chapters. As you may know, Genesis is part of the Pentateuch or Torah, which encompasses the initial 5 books of the Bible. While originating from diverse times and places, these texts were eventually compiled into their current form over the centuries, turning our attention to Genesis, which means origin. It unfolds the creation of the earth, sea, and sky. Within this backdrop, it narrates the journeys of specific individuals who seek a place to call home in the ancient world. The initial portion of Genesis is concerned with beginnings. The Genesis setting. The first verse of Genesis declares, "In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth." Subsequently, chapter 1 depicts harmony in the natural world. A useful analogy is that of a film. It starts with a dark screen accompanied by the sound of churning waves. Then a voice breaks the silence saying, "Let there be light," and a nascent light emerges. The narrative progresses as light alternates with darkness, marking the passage of each day. This creative rhythm continues as God's voice brings about the sky and sea, followed by the emergence of dry land from the sea. Gradually, vegetation sprouts on the land, and days progress with evenings and mornings, forming the third day. On the fourth day, the light transforms into the sun, moon, and stars, while the fifth and 6 days witness the teeming life of sea, sky, and land, including human beings who are also an integral part of the natural order. The distinctive aspects of humanity. The Genesis narrative provides 2 notable characteristics of human beings. First, humans are created in the image of God, implying a unique relationship with the world akin to God's own relationship with it. Second, they are entrusted with dominion over the earth, which implies responsibility rather than domination or destruction. Character development. Chapter 2 of Genesis delves into character development. The text showcases character traits through the narrator's description and the way characters interact with others. For instance, God forms a man from the dust of the ground using wordplay to connect humanity, which is Adam, to the earth, Adama, in Hebrew. Furthermore, the man is placed in the Garden of Eden, where he is meant to work and keep it, emphasizing the importance of caring for the world. Notably, the man's isolation is addressed by creating animals and birds, establishing a relationship with them through naming. However, the narrative suggests that having relationship with animals alone is not sufficient. Hence, God creates a woman from the man's rib, signifying their close bond. This bond is reflected in the names Is for man and Isha for woman in Hebrew. And the harmony persists as they live together, unashamed of their nakedness. The plot complications. As the plot unfolds in chapter 3, disruption of harmony becomes central, brought about by a serpent that capitalizes on human beings' inclination to resist limitations. God had allowed humans to eat from any tree in the garden except the tree of knowledge of good and evil, warning them that eating from it would result in death. The story deals with human desires to transcend these limits. The serpent cunningly questions God's command, leading the woman to eat the forbidden fruit. Contrary to God's warning that they would die, they do not die immediately, but gain knowledge of good and evil. This knowledge brings shame and disrupts the positive relationship they had with each other and with God. They blame each other and the serpent for their actions, and this disruption leads to God's negative judgment. The mutuality between women and men gives way to male dominance, and humanity's relationship with the earth is also affected. Work becomes arduous and mortality is introduced. The story concludes with humans acquiring knowledge but facing the consequences of their actions. God recognizes that knowing what is good does not guarantee doing what is good, and that humans might attempt to seize immortality by partaking of the tree of life. Thus, they are expelled from the garden. As a literary work, the story of Genesis is set in primordial times, but serves to shape perspectives on the present world. It highlights the contrast between the harmony intended by God and the disruptions caused by human actions. On one hand, people are meant to care for the earth and its creatures, and women and men are intended to be partners in this responsibility. On the other hand, human actions have damaged the earth and its relationships. Noah in the flood. The narrative progresses from harmony to disruption, but Noah's story brings it to a point of renewal with the flood account. Genesis chapter 6 to 9. While often simplified in children's literature, the story encompasses more intricate elements. God's warning to Noah, the construction of the ark and gathering of animals, the 40 days and nights of rain, and the appearance of a rainbow symbolizing God's promise never to send such a flood again are key components. In its essence, it is a story of deliverance and renewal. However, a closer examination of the story raises troubling questions. It seems inexplicable for God, portrayed as the Creator, to bring about such a disaster. The focus often remains on Noah and the animals safely aboard the ark. But the larger picture reveals the people and animals outside the ark who perish in the deluge. The complexity of God's portrayal emerges in Genesis chapter 6, verse 5, where divine grief is expressed. God regretfully observes humanity's embrace of evil, leading to the decision to wipe them out. This decision creates a dilemma for God, as annihilation would transform the Creator into the destroyer. Noah plays a crucial role in this context. God instructs Noah to save the animals, thereby linking destruction to renewal and preserving continuity. Noah's task is to tend to the well-being of creation, not just for his own survival, but for the preservation and renewal of all species. The Tower of Babel. Chapter 11 introduces the story of the Tower of Babel, which revolves around the power of communication and its misuse. Initially, all people share a common language, raising the question of how they will employ this power of communication. Previously, God used words to bring forth life and harmony. In the Tower of Babel account, however, the power of communication takes a negative turn. People employ speech to construct a city and a tower that aims to reach the heavens. This narrative continues the theme of humans exceeding their appropriate limits. Their intention is driven by arrogance and the desires to establish their own reputation. God intervenes by disrupting their ability to communicate, putting an end to the project. The writer employs language play as the project is referred to as Babel, meaning Gate of God in Hebrew. While the writer comments that it turns into Balal, which means confusion, thus the attempt to reach the Gate of God disintegrates into confusion. Where has the plot line in Genesis chapter 1 to 11 taken us? In Eden, humans disrupted God's design, and at Babel, God disrupts their plans.
Stay enthralled with epic sagas and ageless wisdom. Continue with us in our Bible as Literature series. Unearth stories and symbols in a fresh literary light. The next chapter of your riveting journey is just around the corner. Thank you for immersing yourself with us today as we traverse the intricate tales of Genesis. From the pristine beginning to the Tower of Babel's confusion, we've seen a dance between divine intent and human ambition. Each chapter, each narrative sheds light not just on primordial times, but our very essence and relationships. If this voyage through the Bible has resonated with you, don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell. Our next episode, The Promises to Abraham and Sarah, promises deeper revelations and insights into faith's very foundation. Join us as we journey alongside pivotal figures and dissect layers of profound emotion, faith, and promise. Until then, keep exploring, and we'll see you in the next episode.